Throughout the month of November, I did a whole lot of railfanning. In addition to making my usual stops on the CSX Trenton line, I also filmed a few trains I had never seen before. I made my first visit to New Jersey Transit's North Jersey coastline, and the following week, I caught a Conrail Shared Assets train in southern New Jersey, one that I've been trying to catch for a pretty long time. In this episode of Area Railfanning, we'll see a variety of power at a variety of locations. Starting off with a CSX intermodal train with a trio of full-throttled GEs, we'll get a change of pace as we make a quick dash eastward to catch a New Jersey Transit train near the Jersey Shore. Conrail lovers will enjoy the return to Woodbourne the next week, where we'll see one of five remaining Conrail Blue Standard Cab Dash 8s. After catching another train, we'll head south to Conrail Shared Assets in Burlington, New Jersey, where we'll catch the only GP40-2 on CSX's roster that is still operating in Conrail blue paint. Several other sightings will bring a satisfying end to November, and one particular train will bring a satisfying start to December. We'll wrap up this episode with a CSX light engine move consisting of two special rarities from the CSX roster. The date is November 7th, 2010, and the train is Q174. After getting a stop signal at CP Woodbourne to let a SEPTA train pass through the nearby interlocking, Q174 roars from the stop with a trio of GE locomotives doing the honors. The very next day, my friend Adam and I took a trip to the eastern edge of New Jersey, doing a large survey of New Jersey Transit's North Jersey coastline. Stopping in the town of Spring Lake Heights, we caught a train gliding through town during a light rain shower. Next weekend, I woke up at around 11 o'clock a.m., immediately furious and in a frenzy. Not only was my alarm clock supposed to have gone off at 8 a.m., but after checking my phone, I found out that Q702 was heading my way with the Conrail Blue -840C in the trailing position. Luckily, I made it out to the tracks with more than enough time to spare.
Thank you.
2 days later, I caught Conrail Shared Assets train WPBU-11 operating in push-pull mode. CSX GP40-2 number 4412 was on the front. I like this unit not only because it still has its Conrail-era Leslie RS3L, but the fact that the horn is still mounted right above the cab makes this engine even better. The unit shoving on the end, however, is CSX GP40-2 number 4428. Saturday, I made a brief stop along CSX's Trenton line to introduce a friend of mine to railfanning. Setting up a little down from Woodbourne, we'll see westbound trash train Q703 make some noise as it passes with recently repainted SD40-2 number 8058 trailing. I caught this engine countless times in the beginning of the year while it was still in worn down YN2 paint. And we're now on our last trip for November. Only a few minutes after arriving at Woodbourne, I caught Q190 heading eastbound in the morning light. Unfortunately, the cold morning air came with it. Later on, Norfolk Southern sent a light engine move out of Marsville Yard, symboled 962. However, the light engine move that really put a smile on my face came on December 11th. The final train of this episode is one that contains quite a few unique engines. Eastbound light engine move X037 had an SD70 ACE leading, with the trailing units being an AC60 CW, ES40 DC, SD40-2 in YN1 paint, and a rebuilt SD50. There are only 20 SD70 ACEs on CSX's roster, and only 16 locomotives left in the YN1 paint scheme, making this power move a pretty cool one. that wraps up this episode of Area Railfanning. I hope that you've enjoyed these trains, and that you'll tune in for the next new video, featuring a chase of a train whose conductor is Santa Claus. Thanks for watching Trainiac Productions, your home for Delaware Valley Railroad videos.